Celebrating Radhashtami festival to remember the Divine Mother, to ponder over the importance of her personality and its significance in our devotion, to pray to her to bless us. For all of these, it is important to understand who is Radha. The question arises because we hear there are three entities in creation. There is one Bhogya Brahma, which is Maya. The second is Bhokta Brahma, which is the jeev or the soul. The third is Premrarak Brahma, the inspirer of both of these, which is Bhagavan. So the Vedas are very clear. There is Jeev, Maya, and Brahma. Now, which of these three entities is Radha? Or is Radha a fourth entity? Radha is she, who is the Atma of Lord Krishna. Another way to understand it is that Radha is the Hladini Shakti of Krishna. So, like for example, we have Shaktis, right? You have the Shakti to see, and when the Shakti reduces, you put on glasses. You have the Shakti to hear, and when the power goes down, then you put a hearing aid. You have the Shakti to understand, and when Swamiji speaks a little complicated philosophy, you say, hey, what is this? So we all have our Shaktis, but they are limited. Now Bhagavan has got Ananta Shaktis. Anant, infinite powers. The supreme amongst them is the Hladini Shakti. That Shakti which gives bliss to Sri Krishna. So Radharani is that Shakti, the Hladini Shakti. And that is why she is super expert in giving bliss to Sri Krishna. She knows all the tricks. Radharani makes Sri Krishna long for her so much that Krishna only sees Radha everywhere. Prasade sa dishi dishi cha sa prishtatah sa purah sa paryanke sa pathi pathi cha sa tadviyoga turasya Hango cheta prakritir para nasti me ka pisa sa 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 jagati sakale koyam advaita vada. Krishna is saying, everywhere I look, I see Radha, Radha, Radha. That is the expertise of the Hladini Shakti Radharani, that she gives so much of bliss to Krishna that he becomes completely absorbed in Radha consciousness. And she is the expert lover. So from her we understand the meaning of love. And she teaches those fine nuances to the gopis as well. One gopi, she put on wonderful shringar. She was an upasak of Madhurya Bhav. She used to look on Krishna as her beloved. And she thought that Krishna will look at my attractive dress and he will find happiness. So putting on her best dress, she went to meet Krishna. But Krishna at that time was a little sleepy. His eyes was closed and he was dozing off. The gopi said, I had come to give him happiness and he's dozing off. So she took the flower and its parag pollen, she started blowing on Krishna. That I hope he wakes up and then he will look at me and he will become happy. But Radharani came and she said, Ari Sakhi, this is not love. You want that he should see you and become happy and that will give you happiness. Your own happiness has sneaked into this unwittingly. You need to be mindful only of Krishna's happiness and not sneakily allow your mind to relish it for itself. And that is the love of Radha. In front of Radha, Krishna's almightiness finishes.